Today in electric potential and capacitance, now to see one numerical. Two charges 5 into 10 to the power minus 8 coulomb and minus 3 into 10 to the power minus 8 coulombs are located 16 cm apart. At what points on the line joining the two charges is the electric potential zero? Take the potential at infinity to be zero. Here there are two possibilities. First possibility, let charge Q1 is equal to 5 into 10 to the power minus 8 coulomb and Q2 is equal to minus 3 into 10 to the power minus 8 coulomb are placed at a point A and B respectively. AB is equal to 0.16 meter. You can see in the figure also, A 5 into 10 to the power minus 8 and B minus 3 into 10 to the power minus 8 coulomb, and the distance between these two charges is 0.16 meter. Let the electric potential at point P, just you can see in the figure, point P is 0. The electric potential at P is V is equal to V1 plus V2. The potential at 0 at point P, so 0 is equal to KQ1 upon X plus KQ2 upon 0.16 minus x. 0 is equal to 5 into 10 to the power minus 8 upon x minus 3 into 10 to the power minus 8 upon 0.16 minus x dividing by k. 3 into 10 to the power minus 8 upon 0.16 minus x is equal to 5 into 10 to the power minus 8 upon x. 3 upon 0.16 minus x is equal to pi upon x. 3x is equal to 0.8 minus 5x, therefore 8x is equal to 0.8. x is equal to 0.1 meter. It is 0.1 meter away from 5 into 10 to the power minus 8 coulomb, or it is 0 from 0.06 meter away from the minus 3 into 10 to the power minus 8 coulomb. 0.06 meter is equal to 6 meter. Second possibility, Q1 is equal to 5 into 10 to the power minus 8 and Q2 is equal to minus 3 into 10 to the power minus 8, and the point, the field at the point P outside from this line joining charges are A and B. So you can see here, this is a 16 centimeter. And A to P, that is x centimeter, therefore P to B is x minus 16 centimeter. Therefore V is equal to V1 plus V2. 0 is equal to KQ1 upon x minus KQ2 upon x minus 16. Q1 upon x is equal to Q2 upon x minus 16. 5 upon x into 10 to the power minus 2 is equal to 3 upon x minus 16 into 10 to the power minus 2. 5 upon x is equal to 3 upon x minus 16. 5 upon 5x minus 80 is equal to 3x. Therefore, 2x is equal to 80. Therefore, x is equal to 40 centimeters. So, 40 centimeters away from Q1 charge, or 24 centimeters away from Q2 charge. A regular hexagon of a side 10 cm has the charge 5 microcoulomb at each of its vertices. Calculate the potential at the center of the hexagon. Solution, you can see in the figure, A, B, C, D, E, F is the hexagon as shown in the figure. It has a side 10 cm and has the charge 5 microcoulomb at each of its vertices. O is the center. Here the 6 equilateral triangle meets, you can see in the figure also, at every vertices has the charge of 5 microcoulomb. Then the electric potential at the center V is equal to 6 into KQ upon R. Keeping all these value, we can get here 6 into 9 into 10 to the power 9 into 5 into 10 to the power minus 6 upon 0.1 is equal to 2.7 into 10 to the power 6 volt. two charges, 2 microcoulomb and minus 2 microcoulomb are placed at the points A and B 6 cm apart. A. Identify an equipotential surface on the system and B. What is the direction of the electric field at every point on this surface? A. Plane passing through midpoint C of a line AB which is shown in the figure. It is perpendicular to AB, just you can see here. A 2 microcoulomb and B minus 2 microcoulomb equipotential surface, that is C. Electric potential at point C, V is equal to K into 2 into 10 to the power minus 6 upon 0.03 plus K into minus 2 into 10 to the power minus 6 upon 0.03. Keeping this value, we can get here both are 2k into 10 to the power minus 6 upon 0.03 minus 2k into 10 to the power minus 6 upon 0.03 cancel to each other and finally we can get 0. Hence the plane passing through point C is an equipotential surface. Electric potential at every point of this surface is 0. We know that the direction of the electric field is from positive charge to negative charge. Hence here the direction of electric field is from point A to point B and it is perpendicular to the equipotential surface. The equipotential surface remains as it is. A spherical conductor of radius 12 cm has a charge of 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 6 coulomb distributed uniformly on its surface. What is the electric field inside the sphere, just outside the sphere, at a point 18 cm from the center of the sphere? A. The field, electric field inside the sphere is zero. Electric field on the surface of the sphere can be considered on the center of the sphere. The electric field at a point R greater than capital R from the center of the sphere is ER is equal to KQ upon R square. K means here 9 into 10 to the power 9 into 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 7 upon 0.12 whole square is equal to 10 to the power 5 Newton per coulomb. C. The electric field at a point x is equal to 18 cm from the center of the sphere is E 18 is equal to KQ upon x square is equal to 9 into 10 to the power 9 into 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 7 upon 0.18 whole square is equal to 444 into 10 to the power 2 is equal to 4.44 into 10 to the power 4 Newton per coulomb. A parallel plate capacitor with an air between the plates has a capacitance of 8 picofaraday, that is 1 picofaraday is equal to 10 to the power minus 12 Faraday. What will be the capacitance if the distance between the plates is reduced by half and the space between them is filled with the substance of dielectric constant 6? Capacitance of the capacitor with air as a medium between the plates CO is equal to epsilon 0 A upon D. 8 into 10 to the power minus 12 is equal to epsilon 0 A upon D. Now the dielectric field between the two plates of the capacitor and the distance between the plate is reduced to half, then the capacitance will be C is equal to K epsilon 0 A upon D by 2 is equal to 2 K epsilon 0 A upon D. C is equal to 2 into 6 into 8 into 10 to the power minus 12 is equal to 96 into 10 to the power minus 12 Faraday, or C is equal to 96 picofaraday. 3 capacitors, each of capacitance 9 picofaraday, are connected in series. What is the total capacitance of the combination? And B. What is the potential difference across each capacitor if the combination is connected to the 120 volt supply? A. Capacitance of the each of the 3 capacitors, C is equal to 9 picofaraday. Equivalent capacitance Cs of a series combination of a capacitor is 1 upon Cs is equal to 1 upon 9 plus 1 upon 9 plus 1 upon 9. That is, we know that 1 upon Cs is equal to 1 upon C1 plus 1 upon C2 plus 1 upon C3. So we will get here 3 upon 9. Therefore, 1 upon Cs is equal to 1 by 3. Therefore, Cs is equal to 3 picofaraday. Now, here all these three capacitors are in a series and with 120 volt. So we can get capacitance of each of these three capacitors is the same, and all capacitor are in series. Suppose the potential difference across C1, C2 and C3 are V1, V2 and V3 respectively. Therefore, V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. Therefore, 120 is equal to 3V1 or 3V2 or 3V3, because V1 is equal to V2 is equal to V3. Therefore, V1 is equal to 40V. Therefore, V2 is equal to 40V and V3 is equal to 40V. Second method for V is all three are series, so V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. Suppose the charge on each of these capacitor is Q. Therefore, 120 is equal to Q1 upon C1 plus Q2 upon C2 plus Q2 Q upon C3, that is all charges are same, so therefore 120 is equal to Q upon C1 plus Q upon C2 plus Q upon C3. C1, C2, C3 also all are same, so finally we can get here 120 is equal to 3Q upon C. Therefore, 3Q upon C means 9 into 10 to the power minus 9, and therefore C1 is equal to C2 is equal to C3 is equal to C is equal to 9 into 10 to the power minus 12 faraday. Therefore, Q is equal to 360 into 10 to the power minus 12 coulomb. Therefore, the total potential difference across each capacitor V1 is equal to V2 is equal to V3 is equal to Q by C is equal to 360 into 10 to the power minus 12 upon 9 into 10 to the power minus 12 is equal to 40 volt.